सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति 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 ही ओम नमः पाणिनिकात्यायन पतंजलिभ्यः शब्द विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो मुनिभ्यो गुरुभ्यः नमस्कारः and welcome to 225th class. We have been studying Atmanepada now, the second set of the Kriyapadas or the verbs and the derivation declension of nouns has been completed in all the seven cases in the previous book, and this book opens with the Atmanepada, the second set of the verbs, which are divided into two sets, Parasmaipada and Atmanepada. So we studied so to some extent in the Latlakara present tense, and soon we'll be studying all the important five tenses in the Atmanepada, like lung, lrut, lot, vidhiling, etc. Slowly they are coming up now. So once we make a thorough study of these verbs Srinivas in Parasmaipada and Atmanepada, the verb study is almost done, you can say, except some tenses which are reserved for higher study. So Atmanepada and Parasmaipada, if you have an idea what the difference like and how they are derived, then a good grip in language can be expected. So we go to do some abhyasa here immediately after some story, like 149 abhyasa. Pata adharena riktasthanani purayat. Now fill in the blanks on the basis of the santati hi kasmaina rochati. Whom does not the child, who does not like the child rather, that we studied in the previous class. And so Srinivas, you can take up this.
Udaharana Shishu Shishu Kasmai Na Rochate. Second one, Mata
Shishave
Dham Dham Datte.
Datte, yes. Mata, this is there in the story, 1, 2, 3, 4th line, those who are watching and have the books, yes, 4th line, it is there. Mata Shishave Dugdham Datte. Datte is gives. Verb like yachati, dadati, mata shishave dugdham datte, you should be able to understand fully all the grammatical points here. Matru shabda prathma, shishave sishu shabda ukaranta pullinga chaturthi ekavachana, and because dana is given here, something given is involved. Dugdha shabda is napumsakalinga, milk. Mother gives milk to the child. In the Sishu Hu Kasmaina Rochate, that is the title there. Who does not like the child? Yes. Third one.
Mata Bahuvidham Kashtam Sahate.
Sahati. So, Mata Bahuvidham Kashtam Sahate. Again, Matru Shabda Bahuvidham is used adverbially here. Kashtam is in Napumsakalinga Shabda. Kasta Shabda is Akaranta Napumsakalinga. Kashtam Kaste Kastani. Even Dugdha Shabda is Napumsakalinga Shabda. Dugdham dugde dugdhani, like vana shabda. So mother sahate means puts up with all types of hardships. Mother tolerates. Bahuvida means various types of custom, hardship or difficulties. Fourth.
Saha mataram pitaram cha vandate.
Yes. Saha mataram pitaram cha vandate. Saha is a boy here, balakaha, shishuhu, or balaha, whoever it may be. Now look at the two words used in dvitiya ekavachana, second objective case, singular number, dvitiya ekavachana. Mataram, pitaram, both are going in the same way. Matru shabda, dvitiya ekavachana, pitru shabda, dvitiya ekavachana. And nama, what is the word? Sevati. Saha. Vandati. Where is it?
It is in second paragraph.
Second paragraph. Oh, we have gone to second. Yeah. Vandati. Mataram pitaram cha vandati. He salutes both mother, not both, mother and father. He salutes mother and father. There is a literal translation. Fifth. Simple.
Saha Kintu shvashurat kinchit lajjate.
Lajjati. So here is a last line in the paragraph, you can show them. Kintu shvashurat kinchit lajjate. Like the daughter-in-law speaks freely with her mother-in-law, but shies away little from the father-in-law. That is swasrat kinchit lajjati is the verb you should use. So rapidly we sum up these five sentences. Mata shishave dugdam datte, mata bahuvidam kastam sahate, saha mataram pitaram cha vandate, kintu swasrat kinchit lajjati. So these are the verbs here, datte, sahate, sevate, and
vandate
and yes, lajjate, vandate, lajjate, these are the verbs to be used there, and we go to the next immediate, adholikitanam, atmane padikriya padanam, bahuvachana. Now you have to practice the bahuvachana, the plurals of atmane pada, of course we are doing that. Ekavachana, bahuvachana, one example is given. Jayate become jayante. Verb practice. Verbs derived in singular, from singular to plural. So if you remember Srinivas, in the Parasmaya Pada, anti comes. Gacchanti, dhavanti, pashyanti, likhanti. Here it becomes ante. Sahante, bhashante, vindante, sevante, etc. etc. Now then jayate become jayante.
Vardhante,
ramate,
ramante.
Oh no, we are going this.
Rahate.
Yes, sahante,
vardhate,
vardhante,
shobhate,
shobhante,
ramate,
ramante,
sevate,
sevante,
yatate,
yatante,
bhashate,
bhashante,
labhate,
labhante.
Vartante.
Any verb where the meaning is somewhat difficult or something? Srinivas? Jayate means is born. Jayante are born. I will tell you. Sahate means tolerates. Tolerate. Sahante. Vardhate grows. That is simple. Shobhate shines. Ramate enjoys. Sevate serves. Yatate strives. Working hard. Striving. Yatate strives. Bhashate speaks. Labhate gets. Vartate means is there. Vartate means is there. So vartate, vartante. So you derive all these 10 on the basis of jayante. Jayate is born. You know. It's a very simple exercise. So vardante, ramante, yatante, labhante, sahante, shobhante, sevante, bhashante, vartante. You can rapidly do on the same line. Third one. Lat lakare sesha rupani likata. Now you write the remaining forms what is given here. Like one verb, like one of our students asked a question through mail that so how many forms does a verb have? Every verb has, that means it is derived in three persons and three numbers, and therefore it has 9 forms. Every noun, yes. In each tense, every tense will have 9 forms as far as the verbs are concerned, kriyapada. Whereas if you take a noun, there will be 21 forms, 7 vibhaktis, 7 cases into 3 numbers. I am not including the sambodhana, which is a part of the prathama. If you include sambodhana prathama, then 24 forms, that will be very baffling. So better you take only 21, 7 into 3, 3 into 3. This is the picture of the verb and the nouns. So it is simple practice. Labhate, you can go ahead. Labhante, labhase,
labhethe,
labhadve, labhe,
labhavahe,
labhavahe. That's it. You make one as a model. I repeatedly tell you, I think that what is given in the book is Vandate is given on page the previous 363. Go back to 142 Abhyasa. Vanda dhatu is given, the verb. That is better, I think better than labha, where you have mahaprana. Vandate, vandete, if you remember, well and good. Or you can take any other, jayate, jayate. So, labhate, labhete, labhante, third person. Labhase, labhete, labhadhve, labhe, labhavahe, labhamahe. You know the meaning of labha, to get. We move on to read some, Srinivas, you can read. Now here, Srinivas, the direction is given. Parasmai padinaha, atpani padinaha, ubhaya padinaha cha dhatavaha. There are three types clubbed together here. Parasmai padi, atmane padi and ubhaya padi. Yeah, you can read.
Balaha shalan gachati, chatraha pustakam pachati, shishyaha gurun vandate, putraha mataram sevate, pachakaha pachati, rameshaha odaram pachate.
So at the end, the two pictures are ubhayapadas. Pachati dhatu is given in ubhayapada here. Balaha shalam gachati. Boy is going to the school, goes to the school. Boy goes to the school. So gachati is parasmayapada. Chhatraha pustakam pathati. Student reads the book. Parasmayapada. Shishyaha gurum vandati. Student salutes the master. Atmanepada. Vandati. Gurum vandati. No more vandati. Putraha mataram sevate. Son serves his mother. Mataram sevate. Atmanepada. Whereas pachakaha pachati. A cook is cooking for others. If the same cook were to cook, as I told you in the other class, we can use pachakaha pachate also. If he is cooking for himself, like Rameshaha odanam pachati. Mr. Ramesh is cooking rice here for himself, maybe for his own consumption. Odanam pachati is cooking rice. I would not say for himself, etc. That is the given here. So pachakaha pachati, cook cooks, Ramesh also is cooking. So you can very easily see here, first two verbs are parasmaipada. Next two, vandate and sevate verbs are atmanepada. Pachati, pachate, same verb, pachati, parasmaipada, it happens to be there in atmanepada as pachate. So I think that is explained in the next page. Yeteshu vakyeshu, in these sentences, sthulaksharaihi, with the bold letters, darshitanam kriyapadanam parishilanam krutam, kuruta. You do watch the words given in bold, we have already done that. Gachati, patati, vandate, sevate, pachati, pachate, ityadi kriyapadani santi. Atra kaha visesha. The book is asking you to find out what is the significance, what is the visesha, what is special about these words. Gachati, patati, ityatra, ante, at the end of these two verbs, gachati and patati, ti, asti, the termination, pratyaya, what we call in Sanskrit, pratyaya, and English termination is ti. Vandate, sevate, ityatra, ante, here at the end of these two words, vandate, sevate, instead of ti, the termination is te. Pachati, pachate, ityatra, in the case of the last two verbs, pachati, pachate, ante, ti, te, ubhayam, asti. Same verb is ending in ti, ending in te, therefore it is called ubhayapadi. So, yada dhatunam, further explanation is given. Latlakarasya, because this book is intended for self-teaching, na? Swadhyaya pustakam, this is. So, more explanation is given. Yada dhatunam latlakarasya prathama purushasya ekavachana rupasya ante. When, at the end of a third person singular termination, ti bhavati, you find ti letter, tada dhatavah parasmai padinah bhavanti. That means whenever you see a verb ending with ti, that you take it as parasmai pada. Yada cha ante, when at the end of a verb te is sounded or written, bhavati tada dhatavah atmane padinah bhavanti. They are all atmane padi. That is the only difference. Ti becomes te atmane pada. Yada and when ante ti and or te bhavataha, ubhayam bhavati. When at the end, either ti or te is there, tada dhatavaha ubhayapadinaha bhavati. Then you take them as a ubhayapada, can be used in bodhi sets, I can say. For example, more examples are given here.
Pashyati, tishthati, pibhati, jighrati, vadati, ityadayaha parasmayapadinaha. वंदते सेवते एद्य एधते
स्पर्धते
मोदते
शंकते
इत्यादयः आत्मनेव जनः खनति खनते गृहति
गूहति
गूहति गूहते श्रयति श्रयते हरति हरते इत्यादयः उभयपदिनः.
Now, very simple, anybody can understand. Pashyati, Pashyataha, Titi, Titi is there. They are all Parasmaipada. Vandate, Sevate, Edhate, etc. already are Atmanipada. Khanati, etc. And now, in the last part, Khanati, Khanati. Oblique is there. Guhati, Guhati, etc. Harati, Harati, Ityade, Ubhayapadina. So, Pachati, Pachati. Shrayati, Shrayati. Shri. Shri Dhatu, Guhati, you know the meaning?
Yeah.
Guhatu, hide, hide, Gopani. To fee, to Shri, Shraya. Ubhaya padya. The meaning, how is it, Shrayati? We'll have to see. I am not getting. Somehow it skipped my preparation also. Harati, harate, it is there. Harati means takes away. Shri. Or if simple, dhatu kosha is there. Shri. Okay, I will see. Just now. Lika dhatu, parasmayapadi. Now this is simple. Now parasmayapadi, you have to again go through. Parasmayapadi. Because you may forget. Likati, likatha, likanti. You can read that.
Likhati, likhata, likhanti.
Yeah.
Likhasi, likhata, likhata, likhami, likhavaha, likhamaha.
So what we studied in the first book, Srinivas, lot many verbs, yeah, they come under this. And likhati, likhataha, likhanti, that you can never forget. So similarly, you can derive, just derive for practice sake, tishtati, in the above, take one. In the meantime, I'll look.
Tishtati, tishtataha, tishtanti. Tishtasi, tishtataha, tishtatha. Tishthami, tishthavaha, tishthamaha.
And take the next, pibati.
Pibati, pibataha, pibanti. Pibasi, pibataha, pibata. Pibami, pibavaha, pibamaha.
What is the verb Shrayati here? Become Shraya, Shri, Shri. Atmanepada. Meaning, what is that? Vedic forms. It is a Vedic word that should not have been given. That is why bothering me. Shri means to cause to lean or rest on, lay on, fasten, direct, turn towards, spread or diffuse. So many meanings. Atmanepada, passive voice. To lean on, rest on. Oh, yeah. It slipped my memory. Shri, Shrayati. What is that? Shrayati. Shrayati. Ashraya. Sometimes we slip. It is a Vedic usage, the dictionary says. Not a common this thing. Shraye. Shraye. Ashraya. You got it now? Shrayati. Shrayati.
Take shelter.
Yeah, shelter, to take shelter, Shrayati. So all these verbs, Srinivas, Parasmaipada verbs should be derived like Likati, Likatha, Likanti. So Vandate, I said Sevate model, Vandate can be taken. Now read Vandate, without looking you can tell. If
Vandate, Vandate, Vandante.
Vandase, Vandase.
Vandase, Vandase, Vandate.
Vandadve.
Vande, Vandavahe, Vandavahe.
That's it. Vandate, Vandete, Vandante, Vandase, Vandete, Vandadve, Vande, Vandavahe, Vandavahe. If you know this, you have mastered Lat Lakar, that is present tense. We'll move on to this next. Very simple. Next, Abhyasa. Abhyasa we are going to. Adha, Ekasya Prasmaipadinaha, Ekasya Atmanepadinaha, Dhatoho, Lat Lakare, Rupam, Dattamasti. Tad anugunam, accordingly, anyani rupani likata. Now, one form of the ekavachana is given in of parasmaipada and atmanipada. So, you can do that. That is also translated in the book. The latlakara forms of one parasmaipada, root one Atmanepada root are mentioned, complete the remaining base. So Parasmayapadinaha in left side, Atmanepadinaha. Vadasi, oh, this is total derivation, Srinivas.
Vasati.
Yeah, Vasati.
Vasati.
Again, same exercise. Vasati, Vasataha, Vasanti, Vasasi.
Vasasi.
Yeah, Vasasi.
This is Parasmayapadinaha.
Huh, you have to complete, na? What happened? Vasati, Vasataha, Vasanti, Vasasi, second person. What is your doubt?
Vasasi,
Vasataha,
Vasataha,
Vasatha, Vasami, Vasavaha,
Vasama.
No, why, what doubt you had? You also thought something. Okay. Switch to second. Rochate.
Rochete, rochante.
Rochate, rochete, rochante, rochase.
Rochete,
rochadve.
Roche, rochavahe, rochamahe.
That's it. Third one. Karshati,
karshanti.
Karshasi,
karshatha, karshatha.
Karshami,
karshavaha,
karshavaha.
Vartate, vartete, vartante, vartase, vartete, vartadve,
varte,
varte,
vartavahe, vartamahe, shamsasti, shamsataha, shamsanti, shamsasi, shamsatha, shamsami, shamsavaha, shamsama. Dyotate,
dyotante,
dyotase, dyotete, dyotadve, dyote, dyotavahe, dyota. Dyota means to shine. Dyu. Dyuti comes from this. Dyu. Varshati, this is
varshati.
Simple.
Varshati,
varshatha, varshami. Vikshate,
vikshete,
vikshase, vikshadhve, vikshe, phalati, phalataha, phalanti, phalasi, phalataha, phalatha, phalami. I generally say this is not derivation purpose, okay, but how can a person say, aham phalami, I give fruits? When it comes to usage, you can't use it in Uttama Purusha. How can a person say, aham phalami, naham vrikshaha, kevalam vrikshaha phalati, manushaha na phalanti, manavaha na phalati. Of course, man, woman gives fruit, conceives, that is a different thing. So some may have a doubt that how can this be used in first person, which when phalatu means to bear fruit. So does a man bear fruit? It can't be, na? But when you say phalami, what does it mean? I bear fruit, I give fruit. So how is it understood? For the sake of derivation only we take it, not usage. You got my point?
Yeah.
Edate, edhante, edhase, edhete, edhe, edhatu grow. We have done it already. So this, all this can be done only if you are thorough with the model given there in the book. Abhyasa 151. Pacha. Okay, what is he asking? Adho nirdishtani rupani parasmai padasya atmane padasya va iti koshtake likhati. Now you have to write out in the bracket whether it is parasmai pada or atmane pada. If it is parasmai pada, I would suggest you, those who are having the books, write P. Atmane pada A. If it is ubhaya pada, you write U, English U. That would be simple. So pache patati parasmai pada P. Pache Atmanepada. Ramase?
Atmanepada.
Atmanepada. Munchasi?
Parasmayapada.
Milami?
Parasmayapada.
Parasmayapada. Guhate?
Atmanepada.
Varte?
Atmanepada.
Rochante?
Atmanepada.
Phalataha?
Parasmayapada.
Dhavanti? परस्मैपद परस्मैपद अंति न अवेक्षति आत्मनेपद पालयामि आत्मने परस्मैपद प्रार्थये आत्मनेपद प्रार्थये व्हाट हैपेंड दिस इज आत्मनेपद फर्स्ट पर्सन प्रार्थये प्रार्थयावहे प्रार्थयामहे This is Dashamagana, that is why you may not get it. So far we practiced Atmanepada with two letters, right? Vande, Sahe, Ikshe. Here one letter is extra because this is Dashamagani Dhatu. I told you all the 2002 verbs are divided into 10 classes. And these 2002 verbs being divided in 10 classes are further divided into Parasmaipada and Atmanepada. That is the point. So this is Dashagani Dhatu. So Aya is added there. Like Danda Shabda is there. Dandayati, Chorayati. In verbs like Gachati, Pashyati, Dhavati, you find three letters. Wherever four letters are there, that is supposed to be the Dashagani. So you have a doubt here, Prarthaye.
Gachatha
Parasmaipada. Likhataha Parasmaipada. Vandadhve Atmanepada. Namavaha Parasmaipada. Vartete Atmanepada. Yudhyamahe Atmanepada. Nrutyamaha Parasmaipada. Munchavaha
Parasmaipada.
Bodhadhve. Now, can you come, which is not asked, but we'll do the person and number. Ramase Atmanepada we have done. What person and number it is? Second person?
Singular.
So Madhyama Purusha Ekavachana. Two. Munchasi, second person singular. Milami, first person, Ekavachana. Uttama Purusha Ekavachana, first person. Milami, me. Guhate, third person, singular. Varte. Varte, Vartavahe, Vartamahe. So, Uttama Purusha, first person, singular. Singular. Rochante, third person, plural. Phalataha, third person, dual. Phalati, Phalataha, Phalanti. Dhavanti, third person, plural. Avekshate, third person, Ekavachana. Palayami, first person, Ekavachana. Singular. Now this also Srinivas. Palayami, four letters are there. Dashama. Prarthaye, first person, singular. Gachatha, second person, plural. Likathaha, second person, dual. Madhyama Purusha, Dvivachana. Vandadhve, second person, plural. Namavaha, first person, dual. Vartete, third person, dual. Yudhyamahe, first person,
plural.
Mahe. Nrutyamaha, first person,
plural.
Munchavaha,
first person,
dual. Yodadhve, Bodhadhve, second person,
plural.
So bodhadve means you all understand. Buddha bodha, bodhani. Bodhase bodhete bodhadve. You all understand. Yuyam samskritam samyak bodhadve. So very simple exercise. We move on to some nirdhanaha sumantakaha story. Atmane padinam parasmai padinam dhatunam latlakare pray. So present tense how they are used. You can read Srinivas.
सुमंतक नाम कश्चन निर्धन अस्ति एकदा सह कुतश्चित् भूरि धनं लभते तेन सह संतुष्टः भवति तथापि सह इतोपि अधिकं धनं कामयते कथमपि दैवात् सह तदपि प्राप्नोति तथापि सह न मोदते तस्य आशा वर्धते
Yes. This is actually one paragraph only. We'll read three. Sumantaka nama kaschana nirdhanaha asti. You can very easily understand there was sometimes you can translate a story like there was a poor man by name Sumantaka. Sumantaka nama kaschana, some kaschana, you know, indefinite, nirdhanaha asti. Generally, this asti, when it comes, opens the sentence, we understand it as a past tense. Now you can understand this as there was or there is, anyway, you can take it. Asti kaschana nirdhanaha sumantaka nama. If supposing this was asti were beginning the word, then there was a poor man by name Sumantaka. Positivity that. Ekada once saha kutaschit bhuridhanam lavati. Ekada, which is an avyaya, saha nirdhanaha, that Sumantaka nama nirdhanaha, kutaschit, from somewhere. Kutaha chit. Here also chit is used, Srinivas. Chit chana, kutaschit. From somewhere, this is avyaya, bhuri is adjective. Bhuri came, this word earlier.
Yeah.
Bhuri dhanam. Bhuri is ikaranta adjective. Napumsakalinga shabda. Like vari. Vari, varini, varini, vari, varini. So bhuri is used as adjective for dhanam here. But it won't take bhurim like. Because it is ikaranta napumsakalinga shabda. If you remember vari, varini, varini, and dvitiya also same. Vari, varini, varini. Similarly, we studied dadhi, dadhi, dadini, dadhini, dadhi, dadini, dadini. So, bhuri, bhurini, bhurini, bhuri, bhurini, bhuri. So, bhuri dhanam lavati. Bhuri means adhikam. Some story we got this word. So, once he somehow, from somewhere, saha kutaschit, somewhere, bhuri dhanam lavati. He gets a lot of money. Who? The poor man. Tena saha santushtaha bhavati. He becomes happy, satisfied with that money. Tena means tena dhanena saha nirdhanaha santushtaha bhavati. Tathapi, this is aware, still, even then, saha itopi adhikam dhanam kamayati. Even then, he wishes for more money than what he had. Itopi adhikam dhanam kamayati. So, kamayate is atmanepada. We will locate later. Kathamapi, somehow. Kathamapi means somehow. Daivat, due to luck. Daivat means due to luck. Saha, tadapi, prapnoti. Somehow, due to his fortune or luck, saha, tadapi, prapnoti. Even that he gets. What does he get? That means, saha, tadapi, bhuridhanam, prapnoti. Bhuridhanam, prapnoti. First he gets some money, then he wishes for more money, even then he gets that money also. Tathapi sahana modati. Tathapi still, even then saha na modati, does not feel happy. He does not feel happy. Tasya asha vardhati. His asha, desire, increases. Saha chintayati. He thinks, yes.
Saha chintayati, yadi itopi adhikam dhanam labhe tarhi eva aham shobhe iti. Evameva chintayam saha ratrau shethe parantu
chintagrastaha
saha bahukalanantaram nidram labhate. Nidrayam sthitaha saha ekam svapnam ikshate. Devaha svapne pratyakshaha bhutva bhashante. He Sumantaka, evam acharitum kutona lajjase.
Okay, then pause that. So, saha chintayati, he thinks, yadi itopi adhikam dhanam labhe, he thinks like this, yadi itopi adhikam dhanam labhe, if I get more money than this, itopi adhikam dhanam labhe, yadi, condition, if I get more money than this, tarhi then, you know, generally yadi is followed by tarhi. Yadi tarhi then, eva then only, tarhi eva then only, aham shobhe, I shine. Only then I shine in the society. I look good. More money, itopi adhikam. If I get more than this money, only then I shine. Eva meva chintayan, thinking like this only, saha ratrau seti. Thinking like this, he sleeps at night. Ratrau seti, sleeps. Parantu, but chintagrastaha, because he was worried, na, he was having some desire. So chintagrastaha, being worried, saha bahukala anantaram nidram lavati. He gets sleep after a long time. Say he wakes thinking like that, maybe early morning he gets a sleep. Nidrayam, in the sleep, sthitaha, when he is in the situated in the sleep, saha ekam swapnam ikshati, he sees a dream. Devaha swapne pratyakshaha bhutva, so gods become appear before him, pratyakshaha bhutva, they appear before him, bhashante, and address him like this, hey sumantaka, oh sumantaka, evam acharitum kuto na lajjase, are you not ashamed to behave like this? You are happy with some money, some more money was added, some more was given. To think more money, are you not ashamed? Evam acharitum, to behave like this, kuto na lajjase, why are you not ashamed? Kuto here means why are you not, why? Na lajjase, why are you not feeling shy? I think you have to read now.
Yadi evameva kamayase tarhi tvam durasha grastaha achiram mriyase ataha durasham mapuru alpena truptaha bhava tena tvam jivanasya sarveshu kshetreshu yedhase sukham cha labhase anyatha asamaye nashyasi iti tadaha sumantakaha nidrataha jagaritaha abhavat.
So when God told him, are you not ashamed? Yadi evameva kamayase, if you desire like this only, tarhi then durasha grastaha achiram riyase, you will die soon being caught with greed. Durasha, can take greed. Durasha grastaha achirameva mriyase, you will die soon, taken over by your greed. Ataha, therefore, durasham makuru, don't have greed. Don't entertain greed. Durasham makuru. Alpena truptaha bhava. Alpena dhanena truptaha bhava. Be happy, be content with little money, limited money. Tena, so that tvam jivanasya sarveshu kshetreshu edhase, so that you can grow in all walks of your life. Jivanasya sarveshu kshetreshu edhase vardhase tvam vardhase sukham cha labhase, you will also get happiness. Anyatha or asamaye nashyasi, you will die in
no time.
No, no. Wrong time. Asamaye. Actually, not even wrong time. Asamaya means you will die, you will destroy yourself untimely. Untimely. You will destroy, you will die untimely. Untimely death, we say, na?
Yeah.
That is it. Anyatha asamaye nashyasi. Nashyasi means here mriyase. You can take that atmanipada mriyase. Iti, that, this how the gods told him. Tataha, then sumantakaha nidrataha jagaritaha abhavat. Then he got awake, he woke up from the sleep. Nidrataha means from the sleep. Jagaritaha abhavat means he became awake. Sva svabhavasya krute tasya lajja ajayata. So after he woke up, he felt shy on his own behavior. Svabhavasya krute, for the sake of his own behavior, for the sake of his own greed for more money, tasya lajja ajayata, he had shy, he felt shame for his own behavior. So let us locate here, Srinivas, what are atmanepada and parasmayapada? Asti parasmayapada.
Yeah.
Labhati Atmanepada. Bhavati Parasmaipada. Kamayati Atmanepada. Prapnoti, which means gets. This is Parasmaipada. Modati Atmanepada. Modati means enjoys. Vardhati Atmanepada. Chintayati Parasmaipada. Yeah, Labhe is Atmanepada. Shobhe Atmanepada. Seti Atmanepada. Ratrav Seti. Nidram Labhati Atmanepada. Ikshati, Swapnam Ikshati, sees a dream. Swapne Bhutva Bhashanti Atmanepada. Lajjase Atmanepada. Kamayase Atmanepada. Mriyase Atmanepada. Kuru Parasmaipada. Kuru Ma Kuru. Bhava Parasmaipada. Lot. This is Lot Lakara. Not present tense. But the book wants you to find out Lat Lakara anyway. Edhase Atmanepada. Grow you. Labhase Atmanepada. Nashyasi Parasmaipada. Abhavat past tense. Ajayata past tense. Abhavat, ajayata, both are past verbs. So these are the verbs. So many verbs are there. If you close the monitor, you have to have full understanding of Parasmaipada and Atmanepada to understand the story. So now Abhyasa, now what is the book wanting you to do? Put in one box all the Parasmaipada and put in another. Yeah, pick up now. Asti.
Asti Parasmaipada, Labhate Atmanepada.
Yeah, Asti comes here, Labhate comes here.
Bhavati Parasmaipada.
Parasmaipada. Atmanepada.
Prapnoti
Parasmaipada. Wait. Modati is there. You are jumping. Prapnoti. Prapnoti Parasmaipada. Modati Atmanepada. Right side. Chintayati.
Before that,
Vardhayati. Yeah, Vardhati Atmanepada. Chintayati. Labhe Atmanepada. What we have done just now?
Yes, same.
But do we need to write? So please. Go slowly and just put them into these two boxes which we have done just now. Chaturthah stavakah. Okay, let's go to the next lesson. Again, we continue with Atmanepada Dhatavah. Yetani Vakyani Patata Srinivas read.
Tava yashah vardhatam. Tava putraha jayantam. He Arjuna Vijayasva. हे लक्ष्मण माम अनुवर्तस्य भोः मन्त्रिं तथ्यं भाषस्व हे पथिक भवान अत्र सुखेन शेतां
सो श्रीनिवास हियर द टेंस हैज चेंज्ड इफ यू हैव वॉच्ड व्हाट इज द टेंस लोट लकार प्रयोग आत्मनेपद Lot means imperative mood, Ajnartha. What was the imperative mood of Parasmaipada? If you remember, Bhavatu, Bhavatam, Bhavantu. Bhava, Bhavatam, Bhavata, Bhavani, Bhavava, Bhavama. Ayushman Bhava. That is Sarve janaha sukino bhavantu antu bhavantu. So in Atmanepada, we are lot seeing now. So, tava yashaha vardhatam. Tava yashaha vardhatam. May your fame increase. Tava yashaha vardhatam means may your fame increase. Vardhatam. This is a third person singular lot lakara of Atmanepada. Similarly, Tava Putraha Jayantam. This is Bahuvachana of third person plural. I think the verb will be given, introduced later. Tava Putraha Jayantam means this Rishi is blessing that woman. May sons be born to you. Tava Putraha Jayantam. Jayatam, Jayetam, Jayantam. May sons be born to you. Ashirvada is giving, blessing. Third picture shows, Hey Arjuna, O Arjuna, Vijayasva. Krishna is blessing, who is blessing? Yeah, Krishna is blessing Arjuna, is rider, hey Arjuna, Vijayaswa, may you be victorious. Be victorious. Any problem there? Vijayaswa, hey Lakshmana, Maam Anuvartasva, oh Lakshmana, you follow me. This is also second person singular in Atmanepada. Bhoh Mantrin, O Minister, Tathyam Bhashasva, speak the truth. O Minister, speak the truth. Tathyam, Satyam, Bhashasva. Pathyam is different. Tathyam, this is. Tattva, you know the word Tattva? From that, Tathyam, truth. Bhashasva means Satyam Bhashasva. Tatyam Satyam. Then He Patika, O traveler, Bhavan Atra Sukhena Setam. You sleep here happily. Sukhena Setam means you sleep here happily. So in these verbs, we come across the Atmanepada being used in Lot Lakara, imperative mode, like Vardhatam, Jayantam, Vijayasva, Anuvartasva, Bhashasva, Setam. If you watch Srinivas, Vardhatam and Setam are like same, because they are third person singulars. Antam is Bahuvachana, third person plural. Sva comes in with the Madhyama Purusha, second person singular number always. Huh? Atma Rupanu Bhartaram Labhasva, an Ashirvada. Atma Rupanu Bhartaram Labhasva, may you get a suitable husband. Rishi blesses Shakuntala, Atma Rupanu Bhartaram Labhasva. So like that, you may get Bhashasva, etc. We'll see. You can turn page now. Rupani Savadhanam Patada, now you read carefully these declensions. In Vanda Dhatu is given, Vanda to salute, to respect, Lot Lakare in the imperative mood. Read.
Vandatam, Vandetam,
Vandantam.
Vandasva, Vandetam, Vandadhvam, Vandadhvam.
Vandaihi, Vandavahi, Vandamahi. Vandai, Vandavahi. It is no more Vande. Vande is present tense. Vande, Vandavahi, Vandamahi. Very slight derivation, change here. Vande is present tense, lat. Vandai is lot. Vandavahe is that. Vandavahai is this. So one stroke is present tense, two strokes is lot lakar. In the Uttama Purusha, if you remember. So, well, some more practice is there, abhyasa you have to go to. So if I have to explain, let me explain. Vandatam means may he or she salute. Srinivas. Balakaha Gurum Vandatam. If I say Balakaha Chatraha Gurum Vandatam means may the student, let the student salute his master. Hey Balaka Tvam Vandasva. If I say, I am using third person, second person singular, first person. Hey Balaka Tvam Vandasva. Tvam Gurum Vandasva. Oh boy, you salute your teacher. First person I am coming to. Aham Devam Vandai. May I salute God? Let me salute God. Aham, even Aham is not required. Devam Vandai. If I say Devam Vandai, let me salute God. Or may I salute God, it also means. So in Dvivachan, if you take Vandetam, Balakau Vandetam, let two students salute. Chatrav Vandetam, let us take. Then Yumam Vandetam, you both, Yumam Devam Vandetam, you both salute God or Gurum, whatever. Vandavahai, Avam Vandavahai, may we both salute, let us both salute. Avam Gurum Vandavahai, let us both salute teacher. Plural. Vandantam, let them salute. Balakaha Vandantam, Chatraha Gurum Vandantam, let the student salute God, I mean the Guru. Yuyam Vandadvam, Yuyam Gurum Vandadvam, you all salute your teacher. Vayam Gurum Vandamahai, Let us all salute our teacher. Vandasva vande tham vandadvam. So this is how it goes. Now you practice here. Modatam, you can derive now. Modetam.
Modantam.
No, modantam. Dirga.
Modasva.
Modetam. Modadvam. Modai. Modai.
Modai.
Modavahai.
Modavahai.
Modai, let me enjoy. Modai, modavahai, modamahai. Okay, vardhatam.
Vardhetam.
Vardhantam. Vardhasva.
Vardhetam.
Vardhadvam. Vardhai.
Vardhavahai.
Vardhamahai. Vardhai, vardavahai, vardamahai. Khidhyatam.
Khidhyatam.
Khidhyantam. Khidhyasva.
Khidhyetam.
Khidhyadvam. Khidhyai. Kidyavahai, kidyavahai. Sevasva. Oh, why it is given like this?
Middle is given.
Oh, okay. Only Madhyam Purusha. Okay. Sevasva, sevetham, sevadvam.
First, sevatam, sevetham, sevantam.
Sevasva.
Sevasva,
sevetham, sevadvam. Sevai, sevavahai, sevavahai. So all these should be done on the same, exact on the verb given in the box here. Yeah, Uttam Purusha, but you come down from third person.
Manyatam,
Manyantam, Manyasva,
Manyetham,
Manyadvam, Manyai, Manyavahai,
Manyamahai.
I think this, they should they be able to? Any difficulty so that I can write? No. In writing, or I think they are simple as far as I know. Do you please derive them and understand them? The meanings of the verbs are also known to you. Modha to enjoy, vardha to grow, khidha to feel sad, sorry, sevas to serve, mana to think, manyai. Manyai means let me think, may I think, like that. So please derive these as we have done on the lines of vandatam, vandetam, vandantam. You will get it. 154 abhyasa. He is asking you complete the forms of other numbers. So missing you have to do on the basis of the given.
Yeah. Sahatam. One is already given.
Yeah.
Sahatam, Sahetam, Sahantam.
Over, that is fully given.
Yeah, fully given.
Second.
Bhashadvam.
So what you have to do? Bhashasva, Bhashetam. That's all. Bhashadvam. First one is third person, second one is second person. First, third one is first person now.
Kampai.
Kampavahai.
Kampamahai.
Kampamahai. Yes. Edhasva. Edhetham. Edhadvam. Khidhyasva. Khidhyetham. Khidhyadvam. This we may write just for. Only five sentences. Out of five, one is already done. Now, Abhyasa?
So, 154. Number two. Plural is given.
Plural is given. What is the verb?
Bhashadvam. Bhashasva.
By the way, this is second. Bhashasva bhashi tham. Plural is done. Yeah. This is second person. Should not be mistaken. What is the next word?
Kampavahi. Vivachana is already given.
Vivachana.
Kampai.
Third one,
huh?
This is first person.
Kampai.
Kampai.
Vivachana is given. Kampamahi.
Yes.
Number four. Singular is given. Edhasva.
This is second person. This is person. Singular is given, na? Edhetham. Which person it is?
Second person. Kidyasva.
Kidyatam.
Kidyatvam.
Over. अभ्यास 155 कोष्टके सूचितस्य धातोः उचितेन रूपेण रिक्तं स्थानं पूरयेत् नाउ फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स विद द वर्ब गिवन इन द ब्रैकेट सो वन इज यूजुअली डन त्वं उच्चैः मा भाषस्व बिकॉज़ त्वं इज देयर द प्रोनाउन सेकंड पर्सन सिंगुलर सो भाषस्व इज सिलेक्टेड त्वं उच्चैः Ma bhashasva. You don't talk loudly. Don't speak loudly. Bhashasva. Tvam bhashasva. If supposing saha is there, what will come in the place of bhashasva?
Saha is there.
Saha uchaihi ma bhashatama.
Bhashatama.
Okay. Take fun now.
Tvam katichana dinani kastam sahasva.
Again, tvam is there, subject. Tvam katichana dinani kastam sahasva. Tvam katichana dinani kastam sahasva. You put up with the difficulty for some more days. Katichana dinani, for some days. Kastam sahasva. Like bhashasva, put it sahasva. Two.
Eshaha
samskrutam gnatva modatam. Let this person enjoy knowing Sanskrit. Eshaha samskrutam gnatva modatam. Good. Third. Yuyam. Parikshayam. Safalatam.
Labhadvam.
Yuyam parikshayam safalatam labhadvam. So as you can see the verb second person plural. Your model is vandadvam labhadvam. That means may you all get success in the examination. Yuyam parikshayam safalatam labhadvam. May you all get success in the examination. In Ashirvadartha also it comes blessing. Four.
Mayam sarvasya hitameva kama mahai.
Kamaya mahai. Vayam sarvasya hitameva kamaya mahai. May we wish the good of all of us. Let us wish the good of all of us. So, fifth. Bhavantaha.
Bhavantaha eva asya karanam.
Uhantam, bhavantaha. Bhavat shabda, when it comes to third person only you have to use. So, bhavantaha eva asya karanam uhantam. This Srinivas will write in the next class, the answers on Wednesday. Seven.
Bhavati bhagavantam
sevasva. Sevatam. Bhavat shabda is used. Sevatam. Tam, third person. There is no third person here. Second person. So, Bhavati Bhagavantam Sevatam. Sevatam. Seven. Vatsau
Yuvam Ma
Khidyetham. Hey Vatsau, Yuvam ma khidyetam. Oh children, oh you two children, don't feel sad. Yuvam ma khidyetam. Khidyetam is then the edetam. Khidyetam. 8. Aham nirantaram vardhai. Aham nirantaram vardhai. May I grow ever. May I ever grow. Aham nirantaram continuously. Let me grow. Vardhai. 9.
Putraha mataram.
Sevantam. Sevantam. Putraha mataram sevantam. Let the son serve the mother. Putraha mataram sevantam. If it is putraha, sevatam. Sevatam. Putraha mataram sevatam. Bhaktaha devam sevatam. Chhatraha gurum sevatam. Tam is there? Not there, Srinivas. Third person is. Oh, to see the verb. 10th one. Vayam anudinam.
Come.
Edha mahai.
Vayam.
Vayam. Mahai. Edha mahai. Kampa mahai. Vayam anudinam edha mahai. We grow, let us all grow every day. May we all grow every day. Vayam anudinam means nityam, pratidinam. Edha mahai. Edha mahai. May we all grow every day. So we'll write the answers for the benefit of the students in the next class. Shivam Bhuyat.